it's first Sunday in March, so it should tell us the spring's on the way, even though it doesn't quite feel like it out there. A few announcements for us this morning. Steak Supper is next Friday. Of course, the sign-up sheets are out in the hallway. And there's also sign-up sheets for Easter flowers, for lilies and hydrangeas. The lilies are $7.50 and the hydrangeas are $14. And next Sunday is the last day you can sign up for those. We have a VBS meeting Tuesday night at 6:30, and of course AA at 8. Wednesday is Kids Club and Youth Group. Thursday, Bible study at 6:30. And Saturday, we have Hope and Help for the single mom. Next Sunday will, of course, be the time change. And since it's spring, we need to set our clocks forward the hour. And next Sunday is also one great hour of sharing. If you'll notice in your bulletin this morning, those who have bulletins, we did run out this morning. It's a good thing. It's a very good thing. In that, you'll see two handouts. One of them is for the one great hour of sharing. It talks about it. It has a little envelope in it. If you aren't going to be able to be here next week, please put a dollar in this week. Because that's one of the things about each of these special offerings that we make. If every United Methodist in the United States that is in worship gives $1 for those special offerings, over $6 million will be raised for those special offerings. So it's not like they're asking for lots. And if each of us put a dollar towards that, it'll make a big difference in many people's lives. Any announcements I'm forgetting this morning?
Camp.
We have got camp flyers in. We're starting to get stuff put up on the bulletin board. It's for those going into second grade.
Through
fifth grade. Right, not going into fifth grade, but completing fifth grade. We need to have them in by a certain time, and that's why we have the April 1st deadline on that, so that we can get discounts and those kinds of things, so that we can help as many kids get to camp as we can.
Do you have any questions?
Yeah, if you have any questions, see Jane, and we'll make sure all those things are taken care of. Any other announcements this morning? Okay. So which one of you guys is doing birthdays and anniversaries? Okay, well, birthdays go first.
Thank you. Will you join me in prayer? On page 268.
Thank you.
time to throw stones and a time to gather stones. A time to embrace and a time to shun embracing. A time to search and keep and a time to give up a loss. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear apart and a time to sew together. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace.
If you would, at this time, let us turn to the backs of our bulletins to our prayer list. Would we have joys or concerns we'd like to share this morning or updates on one tomorrow on our prayer list? Yes, ma'am.
I have joys and concerns. Joys, you did your home hearing with us this weekend. The concerns, I've been recently diagnosed with breast cancer, and I'm having surgery for a little bit tomorrow. But another joy is that they found it very small, should be completely curable, and that's thanks to the mammograms. If you know anybody who hasn't had one in a little while, encourage them to get it. It's probably saved my life.
Amen. That's wonderful. We will keep you in prayer, Cindy, and it's good to have them from all their varying distances away with us. As I'm sure George and Pat are saying this morning, as they were kind of surprised it looked like. And that's a good thing. It's joyful to have family, isn't it? It's joyful to have friends and to be able to see smiles and know that you're loved. Would there be any others that we would like to share this morning? Yes, ma'am.
A little baby in Ryan who's not doing very well. I think she has cerebral palsy, failure to thrive. The dad lost his job because he was in the hospital with her. We're just struggling really bad. I think they could use some extra words this morning. Her name's Madison.
Her name's Madison? Okay. We will keep Madison and her family in our prayers that things will go well for her. Would there be any others this morning? Yes, ma'am.
My mom, Ruth Farnsworth, has moved to rehab last week. She's on the she's had ups and downs, but she's hopefully on the road to recovery.
Good, good. We'll continue to keep her in our prayers. Would there be any others this morning? Well, if not, let's go to the Lord in prayer at this time. Dearest Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this day, for each other, for your blessings over this past week, for what you have in store for the coming week, for all those ways that we know that you have been with us, and for all those ways that we've been able to rest on your love and your grace. We come before you this morning, Lord, and we lift up these ones that are on our hearts. We place them in your hands, and we ask that you will be with each of them. We ask, Lord, that you will continue to move in your mighty and amazing way, and that you will just allow lives to be good. We bring Cindy to you, Lord, and we ask that you will watch over her, that you will help all things to go well tomorrow, and that you will allow the doctors and nurses to do all those things for her to be able to hear and say that they've got it all and it's going to be okay. We just ask, Lord, that you will be in that situation. We ask, Lord, that you'll be with little Madison. We know, Lord, that we don't always come into this world easy, and we know that it isn't always an easy life. We ask, Lord, that you will be with her and her family, that you will touch them in your mighty and amazing way, Lord, and that they will just be amazed at how good you make life for them. We ask, Lord, that you will touch her body, that you will touch the family's finances, that you will just do all those things to allow them to have joy, to be able to share that joy with others. Be with them, Lord, for your blessings out upon them. We also ask this morning, Lord, that you will continue to be with Ruth, that you will allow her healing to continue, and that you will allow it to go well, that you will allow all the rehabs for her to be successful, and to help her to be able to get back to doing those things that she likes to do, and allow the healing to just be able through it for us to be able to give you praise and glory and honor. We pray, Lord, for our communities. We thank you, Lord, for those times when our neighbors are you to us. We thank you, Lord, for those times where you allow us to be you to our neighbors. We thank you for your peace and your security and your safety upon our neighborhoods and our homes. And we ask, Lord, that you continue to pour your peace, safety, and security out upon them. We ask, Lord, that you be with our children, our grandchildren, and our great-grandchildren. And that, Lord, you will go with them everywhere that they go. And that they will feel your presence and know that you are there with them. We pray, Lord, for our leaders. We ask, Lord, that you help them to make good decisions for us. And, Lord, you put upon their hearts the things that will make life good for us in this land. We thank you, Lord, for the safety, security, and peace that we live in. And we thank you, Lord, for those who are serving in the military to help care for that peace. We ask, Lord, that you will watch over each of them, that you will surround them with your shield of strength and protection, and that, Lord, you will bring them home safely to their loved ones. We also pray, Lord, for those who do not come home safely. For those who are injured, Lord, we ask that you will help them heal, that you will be with them and their families through the healing process, and that you will allow them to feel your presence. And Lord, for those whose loved ones do not come home safely, we ask, Lord, that you will be with those families, that you will allow them to know that their loved one is in your hands, and that you are watching over them all, that you have good plans for them. We pray, Lord, for those who are in the nursing homes. We ask that you will be with each of them, that you will pour your grace, your peace, your comfort, and your strength out upon them, Lord, and that you will allow their days to be good. We ask, Lord, that you will put smiles on their faces and joy in their heart. And we ask, Lord, that you will bless all those who care for them and all those who visit them. Allow the halls of those places, Lord, to be filled with your blessings, your praise, and your love. Allow it to overflow. We pray all these things, Lord, in your Son Jesus' holy name, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, if you would, let us rise and turn to our hymnals to page 557 for our next hymn this morning. Blessed be the tithe and bodies.
Our Sunday sun, to be our Savior, God sent his son. To be our Savior, God sent his son. To be our Savior, he is the way, he is the truth, he is the life. 'Twas Jesus Christ who came to save the world. 'Twas Jesus Christ who came to save the world. 'Twas Jesus Christ who came to save the world.
He is the way, he is the truth, he is the life.
He gave his life that we might be set free.
He gave his life that we might be set free.
He gave his life that we might be set free.
He is the way, he is the truth, he is the life.
Rose from the grave that we might live again. Rose from the grave that we might live again. Rose from the grave that we might live again.
He is the way, he is the truth, he is the life.
He lives today.
I know he always will.
He lives today.
I know he always will.
He lives today.
I know he always will.
He is the way.
He is the truth.
He is the life.
My name is Jane Vargo. I am the pre-K through second grade Sunday school teacher. This year, our classes have been studying the New Testament, and you can hold it up, and then we learned about Jesus this year. And we have a big book called The Life of Jesus. So we wanted to let you know what we've been learning. So, page. And our first lesson was about when Jesus was born. And Lauren, can you read the verses, please?
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, to the town of David, because he belongs to the house and line of David. He went through the register with him, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there was And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you great good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men, and whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in their hearts. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Obedient to them.
mother treasured all these things in her heart, and Jesus grew in wisdom and stature, and his favor with God and men.
The next page is Jesus was baptized.
Then Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized by John. But John tried to deter him, saying, "I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me?" Jesus replied, "Let it be so now. It is proper for us to do this to fulfill all righteousness." Then John consented. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and laying on him. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my Son, whom I love, and with him I am well pleased."
Our next story was Jesus was a teacher.
Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the wind blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall, because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the wind blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash. When Jesus had finished saying these things, the crowds were amazed at his teaching, because he taught as one who had authority and not as the teachers of the law. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moth and rust do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. The eye is the lamp of the body. If your eyes are good, your whole body will be full of light. But if your eyes are bad, your whole body will be full of darkness. If then the light within you is darkness, how great is that darkness? No one can serve two masters. Either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money. When Jesus heard what had happened, he withdrew by boat privately to a solitary place. Hearing of this, the crowds followed him on foot from the town. When Jesus landed and saw a large crowd, he had compassion on them and healed their sick. As evening approached, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a remote place, and it's already getting late. Send the crowd away so they can go to their villages and buy themselves some food." Jesus replied, "They cannot eat to go away. We give them something to eat. We have here only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. They answered, "Bring them here to me," he said. And he directed the people to sit down and rest, taking the 5 loaves and the two fish are looking up to heaven. He gave thanks and broke the loaves. Then he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the people. They all ate and were satisfied, and the disciples picked up 12 basketfuls of broken pieces that were left over. The number of those who ate was about 5,000 men, besides women and children.
Jesus also healed the sick.
Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness among the people. News about him spread all over Syria, and people brought to him all who were ill with various diseases, those suffering severe pain, the demon possessed, those having seizures in the paralyzed, and he healed them. Large crowds of Galilee, the Decapolis, drew some Judea and the regions across the Jordan the following.
Jesus also performed miracles.
Immediately Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side. While he dismissed the crowd, after he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone, but the boat was already a considerable distance from land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I. Don't be afraid." "Lord, if it's you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," he said. Then Peter got out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus. But he saw the wind and was afraid and began to sink. Cried out, "The Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said. "Why did you doubt?" And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat whispered him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God."
Jesus also prayed and took time to teach us how to pray.
Father, who is unseen. And then who sees what is
will warn you. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them. This, then, is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For if you forgive men when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. After he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountain and sat by himself to pray. Then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to them, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took Peter and two sons of Zebedee along with them, and he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch with me." Going a little farther, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me, yet not as I will, but as you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Could you men not keep watch with me for 1 hour?" he asked Peter. "Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak." He went to his disciples and prayed, "My Father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done." When he came back again, he found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. So he left them and went to bed once more and prayed the third time, saying the same thing again. Then he returned to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Look, the hour is near, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us go. Here comes my betrayer."
Jesus died for us.
As they were going out, they met a man from Cyrene named Simon, and they forced him to carry the cross. They came to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. There they offered Jesus wine to drink, mixed with gall. But after tasting it, he refused to drink it. When they had crucified him, they tied up his clothes by casting lots. And sitting down, they kept watch over him there. Above his head, they placed the written charge against him, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Two robbers were crucified with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by hurled insults at him, shaking their heads and saying, "You who are going to destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. Come down from the cross if you are the Son of God." In the same way, the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and himself, "He's the King of Israel. Let him come down now from the cross, and you will believe in him. He trusts in God. Let God rescue him now if he wants him, for he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" In the same way, the robbers who were crucified with him also heaped insults on him. From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, darkness came over all the land. About the the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, Eloi, Eloi, lama, sabachthani, which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? When some of those standing there heard this, they said, he's calling Elijah. Immediately, one of them ran and got a sponge. He filled it with wine vinegar, put it on a stick, and offered it to Jesus to drink. The rest said, now leave him alone. Let's see if Elijah comes to save him. And when Jesus had cried out again in a loud voice, he gave up his spirit. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split. The tomb broke open, and the bodies of many holy people who had died were raised to life. They came out of the tomb, and after Jesus' resurrection, they went to the holy city and appeared to many people. When the centurion and those with him who were guarding Jesus saw the earthquake and all that had happened, they were terrified and exclaimed, surely he was the Son of God. Many women were there watching from a distance. They had followed Jesus from Galilee to care of his needs. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary and mother of James, Moses, and the mother of Zebedee's sons.
Jesus was buried.
As evening approached, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who had himself become a disciple of Jesus. Going to Pilate, he asked for Jesus' body, and Pilate ordered that it be given to him. Joseph took the body wrapped in a clean linen cloth and placed it in his own new tomb that he had cut out of the rock. He rolled a big stone in front of the entrance of the tomb and went away. Mary Magdalene and the others, Mary were sitting there opposite of the tomb. The next day, the one after preparation day, the chief priest and the Pharisees went to Pilate. Sir, they said, we remember that while he was still alive, that deceiver said, after 3 days, I will rise again. So give the order for the tomb to be made secure until the third day. Otherwise, his disciples may come and steal the body. And tell the people that he has been raised from the dead. This last deception will be worse than the first. Take a guard, Pilate answered. Go make the tomb as secure as you know how. So they went and made the tomb secure by putting a steel on the stone and posting the guard.
Jesus is risen.
After the seventh at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a fine earth. to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, and he has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples. He has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you in Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you." So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them. "Greetings," he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me."
Last but not least, Jesus loves us.
"For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. Be imitators of God, therefore, as dearly loved children, and live a life of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made in us.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible.
I want to say. You guys, do you guys realize that all of these people out here, at one time or another, has done something to make sure that you guys have Sunday school? Whether some of them were ones who did work on some of the woodwork or some of the brickwork, or whether they were Sunday school teachers, whether they were just those who encouraged. What I want you guys to remember, that in 10 years, do you look out there and see anybody about 10 years older than you? See anybody out there about 20 years older than you? See anybody about 30 years older than you out there? Anybody 40 years older than you out there? Maybe even 50, 60, 70, or 80? Yeah? Okay. Yeah, but I want you guys to realize those guys are there for you. As each of you were baptized, as each of you have been brought and raised up in this church, and as each of us around us, that is a part of our vows. That those of us who are older say, we will care for those of you who are younger. Now, do you guys realize that when you guys were, here we go, how old are you?
Six.
How old are you?
Four.
How old are you?
Five.
How old are you?
Nine.
How old are you?
11.
How old are you?
10.
How old are you?
11.
How old are you?
11.
Do you guys realize that when you guys were this age, there were people 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, 60, 70, 80, 90, all those years older than you that cared about you and made sure that you would have the chances that you are making sure that these kids have. That's one of the great things about the church. It goes on. It's always one generation away from extinction, because if we don't tell the next generation doesn't know to tell the ones after them. And that's why this group of kids is so important. Believe it or not, guys, you realize soon it'll be when you guys are sitting out here like this, looking at your kids, and your grandkids, and your great-grandkids, and maybe even in some cases, some great-great-grandkids, and you guys will be supporting them. That's why the church exists, so that we can share the gospel message and that we can know that God loves us. Let us pray. Dearest Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for your love poured out upon us, towards us, shown to us, given to us. We ask, Lord, that you help us each to embrace that love, that you help us each to love you in return, that you help us each to love each other in return. We ask, Lord, that you will, we just give you thanks, Lord, for those who built this building, for those who dreamed the dreams of your church here in McClure. We thank you, Lord, that we are now those who dream the dreams for your church here in McClure. We thank you, Lord, that we are now the ones that are about your business here. And we thank you, Lord, that you love us so. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. If you guys would like to go back and sit down, except for James and Ben, they have work to do. What did you do? Because you guys are special. If you guys would, it is time that we offer ourselves and our gifts to God. So if you guys would you guys take care of the edges? Thank you. dearest Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the many ways that you bless us, for all those ways that you pour your love out upon us and care for us, Lord. We give you thanks. We also thank you, Lord, for these opportunities that you give us to turn our hearts to you and to care for our neighbor. We ask, Lord, that you will take these gifts, tithes, and offerings, and ourselves, Lord, that you will use them for your glory, for your good. We ask, Lord, that you will allow your word to be shared, for your love to be known, and for many hearts to be warmed. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. At this time, if you would, let's turn in our hymnals to page 357 for our next hymn this morning. Verses 1, 3, and 6.
He will forgive our sins and cleanses us from unrighteousness.
May the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heads. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to thee, O Lord, Heavenly Father, Almighty Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hear us, O merciful Father. We most humbly beseech thee, and bless and sanctify with thy word and thy Holy Spirit these gifts of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his passion, death, and resurrection, may be partakers of the divine nature through him, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took the bread, blessed it, and broke it, and passed it amongst his disciples, and said, Take and eat in remembrance of me. He took the cup, he blessed it, and then he passed it amongst his disciples, saying, This is my blood poured out for you and for many, the new covenant for the remission of sins. Do this in remembrance of me. Let us pray. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, we, thy humble servants, desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and thy whole church may obtain forgiveness of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that all we who are partakers of this holy communion may be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And although we be unworthy, through our manifold sins, to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. We do not presume, O Lord, to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness. But in thy manifold and great mercies, we are not worthy so much to gather up the crumbs under this table. But you are the same, Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to partake of this sacrament of thy Son, Jesus Christ, that we may walk in newness of life, may grow into his likeness, and may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. O Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. take and drink in remembrance of Jesus for the remission of sins. If you would, let us rise and turn in our hymn books to page 367 for our closing hymn this morning, He Touched Me.
Thank you.